Hello everyone. So now we are moving on to week number four. As usual, I'm just going to introduce to you what you can expect as work items in the coming week. So for lab number one, so hopefully that was your very first lab, well, excluding lab zero, because for lab zero, it's pretty much you were spoon-fed with what you're supposed to type. But for lab number one, hopefully you already overcome most of the learner's block for the new language. If you're still struggling with the basic syntax for IFO, please get in touch with me so I can help you early. But we have to move on to lab number two and also the rest of the course. For week number four, let me first of all draw your attention to over here about the lecture hours. So you can see over here, I put the lecture hours is actually 3.3 hours. It's like a 20 to 30 minutes heavier than usual. So usually it should just be only 3 hours. So the reason is, so for this week, I'm actually trying to really put everything you would need for lab number two. Remember, your lab number two is released just this week. So they will require drawing design diagram, also about how to create abstraction for your application, and also how to use math models to write contracts, and also how to use an iterator pattern. So these, I'm thinking to cover them in 3 hours, maybe slightly over than 3 hours. It would be better to do this than simply split them off to 2 weeks, in which case the second week you'll be the week where your lab two is due. So it might be better for you to study just for the first week, and then for week number five, I'm going to make it lighter as I did previously for week number three. I'll make it happen. So for week number five, you're also going to get maybe roughly about 1.5 hours and no more. Okay, that's something I can try to do for you. Okay, so that's about the work hours. And then let's see what you actually learned for week number four. Okay, for week number four. So you're just going to learn about number one, about how to draw design diagrams. That will be the first part. And also the second part, you will do some case study for how you can create mathematical abstraction for the birthday book application, which you did in lab number zero. And then the third part will be about your very first design pattern, which is the iterator design pattern. You already actually acted as a client of the iterator design pattern when you actually use the across notation in your lab number zero. So the across keyword, the construct works because of the iterator design pattern that we're going to talk about in this week's lecture. So now this time, not only that, you're going to be about the clients, which I'll just review quickly about how you can use the across keyword, but also you have want to act as the supplier to know how you can implement your own classes to make your own class iterable. Okay, that's something we'll learn this week. And then there will be some optional tutorials over there. So I try to be as intuitive as possible in the lecture materials so that you can work out the technical details rather easily. However, if you really need some hands-on tutorial videos on the programming code or some programming hands-on experience, in that case, you can definitely look at, so these are the two tutorial videos I made to really walk you through the basics of the iterator pattern. And also from from winter 20, there was a lab test review session about how you can make the birthday book, which we talk about in the lecture, about how you can make it implemented by using hash table iterable. That's also relevant. So I make these resources available to you. So if you need more exercises, you want more exposure to the design pattern, please feel free. Okay. And then, so these are the slides you will have to study. They are already up and running. And also, as usual, I give you the templates. I give you and also the iPad notes with the annotation. If you want to study for that, if you want to practice more about the problem I walk through, you can also use them. Okay, so about this exercise, you will all there's one exercise that you are assigned to do this time. So at the end of the iterator pattern lecture, I give you one challenging exercise to do to work out the generic parameter instantiation, especially given multiple classes with a sophisticated architecture. So that's a challenging exercise for you, but I think that will help you also for your lab number two. Okay, and also you can always post your questions on the Google Doc as usual. And then, so these are the diagrams which I think will be beneficial for you to actually study further. Okay, so these are all the resources. They're already up on the lectures page. You can start working on them at your earliest convenience. Okay, let me just talk briefly about what the learning objectives are for week number four. Okay, first of all, about drawing design diagram, you'll learn about it first, about the syntax, about the design rationale, and also about, you know, the various details that you should really do in order to draw your design diagram for your lab number two. For your lab number two, you are also required to submit a design diagram. So this lecture will be very important. OK, Okay, and also the second part will be about, okay, over here, about how you can create abstraction for your birthday book. In the previous week, we learned about how you can use a sequence class to create an abstraction for the Levo stack. But now we learned, just go a little bit more advanced. Let's see how you can use to create an abstraction for a birthday book, like a database, using a mathematical function. And also, you can extrapolate the application you learned to also mathematical relation. Okay, and then we also got your first design pattern. So that'll be this iterator design pattern. So supplier versus client, especially for supplier. For the lab, number two, you will learn, you will be required to actually implement some design pattern for iterator. And finally, this exercise, let me emphasize again, this will be very important for you to complete. In the lectures part, I don't really give you the solution because I really want you to take some time thinking about how to solve the exercise yourself. And then I'll discuss this in the Q&A next week. Okay, so this will be discussed in the Q&A session, either Monday or Tuesday, we'll see. Okay, but it will definitely be discussed. Finally, what will be the milestone for this particular week? So lab number two has been released, so you will need to start with lab number two. Official start day will be September 28th, Monday. Okay, so you'll be given 2 weeks to complete your lab number two. But take my advice, start as early as you can so you can get to me for help or the TA for help in time. And then, so now you also need to complete quiz number three, which is based on your lecture series number three over here. So you want to complete it. And finally, you want to start with your lecture series week number four. That's also very important for you to start. You want to start in time. Don't really start just a few days before the corresponding quiz. It's not the best for your learning. Okay, so yep. Off you go. That's all the work items you can expect for the coming week. So if you got any questions or any struggle with the study, please get in touch with me and then I'm always happy to help. Okay, good luck.